Oshki Annishinabe Nigaaniwak is the City of Winnipeg's Indigenous Youth Strategy. The mission is to give Indigenous youth positive opportunities in the community and civic system by bridging and providing culturally appropriate programs and supports related to employment, literacy, and recreation to increase resiliency, self-sustainability, pride, and future opportunities.
Our vision as an organization is to be a vibrant and healthy city which places its highest priority in quality of life for all its citizens. We are supporting 5 Truth and Reconciliation Commission calls to action, including a commitment to train all 10,000 employees about the history and legacy of residential schools. We have a workforce of tremendous professionals with an equally tremendous commitment to making our city a more inclusive and welcoming home. I am proud of all City of Winnipeg staff in rising to the challenge of working in new ways and building on our successes and knowledge from innovative programming such as our Indigenous Youth Strategy, Oshki Annishinabe Nigaaniwak.
Well, it's really about providing empowerment and opportunities for our Indigenous youth here at the City of Winnipeg. We know that our Indigenous youth are leaders right now in our community, and there's much to be learned from our Indigenous youth. But also we want to make sure that everybody has opportunities at the City of Winnipeg, and where we can leverage the networks and the connectivity that the City of Winnipeg offers with our community through Oshki Annishinabe Nigaaniwak. That's obviously something that we're going to continue to promote and support. And so whether it's the mentorship, whether it's the training, the education that comes along with the program, it's something that's been incredibly positive since it started 8 years ago, and it continues to be something that we just continue to strengthen through our Indigenous Relations Division.
As the youngest and fastest growing segment of our city, Indigenous youth hold a lot of our collective potential. Investing in Indigenous youth ensures the City of Winnipeg is laying out a solid foundation to build a stronger tomorrow. Activities involve building partnerships with community-based organizations in Winnipeg that develop and deliver youth-focused programming related to recreation, employment, and employment development. Some of the community programming the Oshki Annishinabe Nigaaniwak work with include organizations that help foster development and equitable opportunities for Indigenous youth, while providing a safe environment to learn, develop, and reflect. The programs that the Indigenous Youth Strategy support are Resource Assistance for Youth's Growing Opportunities, Boys and Girls Clubs of Winnipeg's Youth Recreation Activity Worker Program, Broadway Neighborhood Center's Just TV Program, Assembly of Manitoba Chiefs Eagles Nest Program, Spence Neighborhood Association's First Jobs for Youth, Mama Wei Chi Itata Future is Yours, Ganaganichik's Honoring Gifts, Urban Circle Training Center's Apprenticeship Training and Employment Program, Center for Aboriginal Human Resource Development's Aboriginal Carpentry and Construction and Trades Program, Indigenous Leadership Development Institute's Indigenous Carpentry Program, Ndinawe Maganag Endawad Youth Resource Recreation Program.
The Youth Recreation Activity Worker Program, that's the name in full, was started about 15 years ago in conjunction with the Boys and Girls Clubs in Red River College. And this program was to provide youth within the inner city that have multiple barriers to post-secondary education the opportunity to combine their life experiences and also give them the educational component to be able to work with children and youth.
So I just recently completed the Youth Recreational Activity Worker Program with Red River College, Association Boys and Girls Club in Winnipeg. I wanted to take this course because I was put on this earth to help others. And helping our youth is helping the world, because our youth is the future.
I just think the Youth Rec Program is a great program. There's still a lot of people who don't even know about the program. There's no cost for the program. The fees are all covered. It's a very unique program that way.
The instructors are always going to be there for me, so I'm so thankful for them, and I'm also so thankful for the opportunities that all the funders gave me to be able to do that program for free. And I'm definitely recommending the course to other students as well.
Just TV has been in existence now since 2007. We run a multimedia program which works with youth between the ages of 16 to 24. We teach our youth in our program how to use the multimedia standard industry equipment such as video production software, audio production software. We have 2 fully functional recording studios And we have technical instructors that go along and are showing the youth how to use the equipment and the software and to make their visions or their dreams, whatever it is that they have in their minds, what they want to portray, become reality.
I heard that back in my school, back in my high school years, this friend of mine, like, he told me, like, hey, Jimmy, like, do you like music? Like, do you want to go to this program? I was like, yeah, sure. I am a mentor here now, like, since I made so many songs here, and I just won and they award off it. I won an award off it in 2015. Yeah, final thoughts is, I want to share this video to everybody that who wants to be somebody. Like, you always follow your dreams. Yeah, you never say no to a opportunity. When an opportunity comes your way, you take that opportunity, you walk into the spotlight, and then you show the person who you really are.
Our program runs on Tuesdays and Thursdays. We run a year long. We start in January, is when we do our intake, and then we have a big showcase at the end of the year in November, where it's a great event where all the youth projects get to be shown, and it's free of charge at the Western Cultural Center for their family and their friends to come in and see.
I like to become a camera operator one day, an editor. How Just TV impacted my life is they helped me out get through my hard days when it was winter, and I was homeless at the time too, which I told nobody for a while. And eventually I found a place of my own, and they've been supporting me ever since. One of the other participants here introduced me, they brought a paper, and that was the Adam Beats Film Institute, and that's where I got into APTN. Just, I guess, even though times are hard, you shouldn't give up.
We'd like to thank Oshki Annishinabe Nigaaniwak for their partnership and their wonderful contribution to our program. Without their funding, it would be very hard to deliver the quality of program that we've been able to do for over the last 10 years. So we'd like to thank you for that, and we look forward to your continued support.
Out of the prior youth who have gone on to do great things are two individuals, DeAndre Thomas Hart and Graham Constant. Both are previous interns of the Oshki Annishinabe Nigaaniwak's Indigenous Youth Strategy who worked at the City of Winnipeg as interns. DeAndre is now working at the Canadian Roots Exchange in Toronto, while Graham is the audiovisual technician at the National Center for Truth and Reconciliation.
Hi there, my name is DeAndre Thomas Hart. My spirit name is Oshkenikasikweo Kawechika Paistawat Makisuak, which means young woman who stands among the eagles, and I'm from the Bear Clan. So what I do here at the Indigenous Relations Division is that my role is the Intergovernmental Project Assistant, and I help coordinate a tri-level working group with provincial and federal reps, as well as city reps. It really helped me direct my focus, and I think that was a big part for me, is because I was kind of all over the place as to where I wanted to go or do after high school. And this kind of gave me a more focused approach as to, okay, what type of jobs can I apply for now? What's my experience from my previous placements? And It brought me to where I am today. It took me to the steps I've taken to where I'm at today in my life. And I feel like I'm doing pretty well for myself. I'd like to say that. And I'm really happy and I enjoy working here.
My name is Graham Constant, and I'm originally from Opaskwak Cree Nation. I moved to Winnipeg to pursue post-secondary education, and now I'm currently working at the University of Manitoba as an audiovisual technician at the National Center for Truth and Reconciliation. As the audiovisual technician, I'm mainly in charge of editing the public statements from different TRC hearings. There have been roughly over 7,000 statements provided to the TRC, and I've heard maybe over 3,000 of them. Working at the city got people to take my resume and what I do a little more serious, because it got my foot in the door, and working for the city, you learn quite a few things aside from what you're tasked to do. It's a great program, and through my internship I learned quite a bit of stuff that I didn't even know I could do. It's a great program to work and collaborate with other people and learn more about the city you live in.
We want to continue to provide those opportunities. This is a place where every citizen, including our Indigenous youth, should be proud to call home, and we need to continue to work forward to building those bridges and those opportunities for our Indigenous youth to make sure that reality is the reality for everyone in our community.